Hello everyone, Ice Cool Tech here. Now, iOS 17 Beta 5 is here, and with it, I have found over 40 new changes and features that I'd like to share with you all today. Now, make sure that subscribe button if you haven't already, and enable notifications, as I will be doing this with every future iOS beta, and I know a lot of you want to know exactly what is new with each release. Anyways, let's get straight into the video. iOS 17 Beta 5 will be on the right for this video, and iOS 17 Beta 4 will be on the left. So, first of all, I want to say that the performance on iOS 17 Beta 5 has been noticeably improved over Beta 4. It is so much smoother than Beta 4 has been. I haven't noticed really any micro stuttering. All the issues that I had with Beta 4 seem to have been fixed in Beta 5. And of course, the battery life has also been dramatically improved. iOS 17 Beta 4 would hardly get me through the day, and now I'm ending with around 60% by the end of the day. This is a huge improvement over Beta 4. iOS 17 Beta 5 brings a new icon for sign-in and security in settings. There is now a brand new animation for entering Spotlight Search in iOS 17 Beta 5. Previously, Spotlight Search would come in from the top and the actual home screen would fade to the back. And now in Beta 5, it actually slides down with your thumb and the Siri suggestions platter actually fades in from the center. When there is no content in the music widget, it now says open the music app to enable this widget. In Beta 4 of iOS 17, there was this long fade-in animation for the hearing platter that has since been removed. Now it just pops up instantly. And in Beta 5, when actual content is playing and the hearing platter is live, there is now a new bounce animation that looks so much nicer, and I don't know why they just don't implement this when there's nothing connected or nothing playing. But it is definitely an improvement. In news in My Sports, there is no longer the option for manage notifications in Beta 5. I'm not sure why this was removed, but it has been. In offline maps, there is now some information text for optimized storage, and now the text for only use offline maps sits right in the cell. And an interesting change in the App Store, open, get, and update buttons no longer use all capital letters. Now this is a change that some people don't like, but I'm actually quite fond of it. And in Beta 5, there's now a new sound that plays when airdropping or name dropping something to somebody else. So let's take a listen. Sometimes the sound doesn't play, sometimes it does, and most of the time when it does play, the ending gets cut off. And as you can hear by that previous clip, it actually ended up playing the normal airdrop sound at one point. So it's pretty glitchy, but it is there. And in Beta 5, there is now redesigned Shazam animations. They are a lot more fun, they look a lot better. In Beta 5, there is now this new prompt to locate your TV remote. And the screen distance text has been updated. Previously it said iPhone is too close, now it says it may be too close. And it now says at a recommended screen distance instead of a safe screen distance. And in settings, there is now a Do More with iCloud recommended for you pop-up. And in settings, in sound and haptics, and under ring mode, the ring mode text now sits quite a bit lower than the actual title. I believe this to be a bug, but it is a change. And in the accessibility settings, there is now a new icon for voice control. And if we scroll down a bit, there is also a brand new icon for assistive access. In the messages settings, there is now a see how your data is managed link under the check-in section. The actual text for limited and full now sits right below the two options. Previously, it sat below the map. And the actual text has been updated. It now says includes most recent location and details about battery network signal for iPhone and Apple Watch. Previously, it said includes current location. And of course, the actual device details here, like the network and battery, have actually been added to the check-in data page and settings. And now when haptic touching on a song in Apple Music, the pop-up here no longer displays the song's information, now it just says view credits. And once again, the state of mind icons have been updated. You can see this was in Beta 4, and this is the current new icon. Now there's a brand new image here for login emotion or mood, and the pleasant text under the slider is no longer black, now it is a lighter gray. And the show more button for what best describes this feeling options is now darker and has a chevron. Previously it was just blue. And just a couple of changes in the weather app here. So in the wind platter, the actual spacing has been revised. You can see that the wind and gusts text are much more centered than they were before. Now the actual divider line too is much more discernible from the background. Previously you can barely see it, but it is there. And of course, the compass is actually slightly smaller, allowing the entire platter to be ever so slightly shorter. In context, there is now a blur at the top of the poster here. Previously, there was no blur. It looks a lot better in my opinion. And the font weight actually works now, as you can see here. This is with the thin font, but it did not work previously. Now it actually does. And Apple has reversed course. The first name is now smaller than the last name. Previously, they had switched it around. In Fitness Plus, the actual icon for the Up Next list has been updated. And if we actually enter this menu here, you will see that Up Next has become Create a Stack. And there is now all new text replacing the old You Can Add Any Workout or Meditation to the Stack. And in shortcuts, there are now new icons for the Safari options here that better represent what the actual options do. And in Beta 5, widgets like Calendar and News are no longer black in dark mode. They are once again gray. I'm not too sure I'm happy with this change, but it is a change in Beta 5. And an exciting new change in the control center, the flashlight icon is now bolder, a little bit more rounded, and it fits in much better with iOS, as you can see right here. And finally, in Beta 5, the share sheet actually shows shortcut icons. Previously, it did not. Alright everyone, that is all of the new features and changes that I found in iOS 17 Beta 5. Now, of course, if you did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like. It took quite a while to make, as always, so a like is really appreciated. And if you haven't already, definitely make sure to hit that subscribe button with notifications enabled. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.